This is Story Recapped. Today, I'm going to explain a fantasy drama romance film called What Dreams May Come. Spoilers ahead, watch out and take care. Chris Nielsen, a pediatrician, and Annie Collins, an artist, meet when their boats bump into each other while vacationing in Switzerland. Since their boats were heading in different directions, they couldn't properly introduce themselves. They can only wave at each other and smile. They soon get a chance to meet again when Annie finds Chris sitting on a nice picnic spot on a hill. The two quickly warm up to each other. Annie and Chris eventually get married and have two kids. Everything appears perfect for the couple as they raise Ian and Marie. As their children prepare to go to school one day, Chris reminds Ian about his math test. Ian assures him that he's ready for it. Marie begs Annie to pick her up early after school, so she wouldn't have to wait for her brother. However, Annie has a meeting, so she'll ask the nanny to do it. As the children are about to leave, Chris gives Marie her lunch bag and reminds her not to trade it for chips and cookies. Soon, the nanny drives the children to school. Chris recounts that it was the last time they saw their children alive. 4 years after the tragedy, Chris and Annie continue to pursue their respective careers. While Chris is seeing a patient, Annie calls to tell him that she can't be at their double D anniversary because she's busy at the art gallery. Chris offers to pick something up for her so that they won't cancel their date. That night, Chris is headed to their meeting place when he witnesses a car accident in a tunnel ahead of him. Chris tries to help a woman in an upturned car, but another vehicle suddenly loses control and crashes toward him. As Chris fights for his life at the hospital, he hears the voice of his mentor, Albert Lewis. When his spirit wanders into his home, he encounters Albert again, but he can't see his face clearly. Chris thinks he's dreaming, but Albert informs Chris that he has passed away. Albert reveals that he appears blurred to Chris because Chris doesn't want to see him, and he doesn't want to be dead. As Chris fights for his life at the hospital, Chris suddenly remembers the time Marie got upset when her dog, Katie, got sick. Marie told Annie that she was going to the hospital with Katie, but the dog was going there to be euthanized, not to get better. Annie tried to console Marie by telling her that Katie would go to a good place. Soon, Chris ends up at his own funeral. Albert is relieved that he's now shedding his fears about his death. He assures Chris that he hasn't disappeared even though he died. Chris then approaches his grieving wife and touches her lip to comfort her. Later, Chris shows Albert a painting Annie gave him to commemorate their double D anniversary. The artwork depicts a man staring at a house across a lake. The man in the painting is Chris, and the house is their dream home. When Chris sees Annie writing in a diary to express her grief, Chris takes her hand and guides her to write a note to tell her that he still exists. Annie sees the note, but she tears the page in frustration. Chris tries to communicate with Annie again as she grieves at the cemetery to tell her that he'll never leave her. However, Annie gets even more distressed. Chris soon realizes that he's only making her more miserable, so he decides to move on. After going through the tunnel where he died, Chris ends up in heaven. When he touches the flowers and his surroundings, he discovers that everything is made of paint. Not long, Katie jumps out of nowhere to greet him. At first, Chris thinks that he ended up in dog heaven, but he realizes that he's in his heaven after looking around his environment and seeing that it's exactly like Annie's painting. As Chris explores his new environment, Albert suddenly calls his attention. Albert, who now appears clearly to Chris, explains that Chris is creating the place using his imagination and memory of Annie's paintings. Later on, Albert reminds Chris that Annie's painting included a dream house. So they decide to go there. Upon reaching the house, Albert notices that there are no windows, so he deduces that there are some things Chris isn't ready to see. Albert thinks that Chris is being held back because he's still thinking of his physical body, so he creates a hole on the wall to show him that his thoughts can make everything real. When Chris looks through the hole, he discovers that the objects are no longer made of paint. Albert points out that thoughts are real in heaven, and physical objects are illusions. Annie soon creates a new art that connects to her painting of their dream house. Not long, the purple tree depicted in Annie's new painting appears in heaven. As Chris and Albert are about to head to the tree to take a closer look, Chris sees Annie trying to set a picnic blanket on a hill. Chris decides to jump off the cliff to reach her. When he lands, Chris immediately dashes to the hill, but Annie is no longer there. Chris realizes that the tree is Annie's new painting, but he recalls that the canvas was empty when he was alive. Albert deduces that Chris can see the new painting even after his death, because he and Annie are soulmates. However, Annie thinks that Chris won't see the painting, so she destroys it. Chris weeps as he sees the tree wither before his eyes. As Chris and Albert continue exploring, Chris suddenly comes across Marie's toys. When Chris asks if Marie is in heaven, Albert suggests that Chris hasn't seen her yet because he's not ready to do so. One day, Chris gets a visit from a woman named Leona. She informs Chris that Albert is busy, so he asked her to meet with Chris. Leona knows that Chris has been isolated since he got to heaven, so she takes him to a city teeming with people. Chris looks at the people in awe as they glide effortlessly through the air. Leona notes that the city is the world she painted for herself. When Chris asks about the jobs in heaven, Leona informs Chris that Albert is a missionary in charge of saving lost souls, while she is tasked with taking care of animals. When Katie approaches them, Leona tells Chris that the dog is her old friend. Annie writes in her diary that she regrets prioritizing her work on their Double D anniversary. She believes that Chris would not be in the tunnel if she weren't busy with work that day. Back in heaven, Chris tells Leona that his children died in a car crash. It was a trucker's fault, but Annie believes that the children would still be alive if she was driving because her motherly instincts would have protected them. When Leona asks Chris to tell her more about Marie, he recounts when he played chess with her. During the game, Marie got distracted by the diorama in her room. Marie asked if the afterlife is like the diorama, which depicts several people hovering in the air just like the part of heaven Chris visited with Leona. Chris told Marie that the diorama is beautiful, but it's only a product of someone's dream. Later on, Leona reveals that she used to look different when she was alive. When she first got to heaven, she changed to look like an Asian flight stewardess she and her father saw during a flight to Singapore. Her father described Asians as graceful and intelligent. Chris realizes that Leona is Marie, so he asks if she still plays chess. Marie tells him that she's been waiting for the right partner. As Annie sinks further into despair, she writes another journal entry, saying she's willing to cross great distances to send her love to Chris. When Albert visits Chris, he reveals that Annie has taken her own life. Chris is somewhat relieved that he'll see Annie soon, but Albert reveals that he'll never see Annie again because people who kill themselves don't end up in heaven. Chris thinks that Annie is being punished, but Albert contends that there are no rules or judges to condemn her. He explains that people go to hell because they don't know they're dead and fail to realize what they've done. Albert asserts that Annie will remain in hell for eternity, because she will never face reality. Chris contends that he can find Annie and bring her to heaven because she is his soulmate. Albert sees that Chris is determined, so he takes Chris to a tracker to help them find Annie. The tracker assures Chris that they'll find Annie because of their bond, but he warns Chris that she won't recognize him because her denial of death is too strong. He notes that Chris can say goodbye just to give him the satisfaction that he didn't give up. On their way to find Annie, the trio comes across a group of people swimming toward their boat. The tracker tells Chris there's no physical danger in hell, but he warns that he could lose his mind. Soon, the people emerge from the water. As the people desperately try to get on the boat, it capsizes due to their weight. As Chris sinks to the bottom, he remembers when his wife pleaded with him to allow Ian to enjoy his childhood instead of pressuring him to succeed in school. During a hiking trip, Chris told Ian that they were pulling him out of school because of his grades. Chris asked Ian to show him more effort, but Ian lamented that he was not as bright as Chris. Ian knew that he was not as good as everyone else, but he's not giving up. Seeing his determination, Chris told Ian that he was the only person he wanted to be with, if he goes through hell. Upon reaching the gateway to hell, Chris realizes that Albert is Ian. Near the gateway, there's a shipwreck filled with vicious guards who impale anyone who tries to enter. When Ian attempts to go through the ship, Chris stops him and tells him that he won't find his mother there. Chris then embraces Ian and reminds him that he's the only man he wants to be with when he goes to hell. not long, the tracker informs them that they'll be taking the elevator to hell. The tracker tells Ian to stay behind because Chris lost Annie's signal since he recognized him. Chris wants to part ways with the tracker to continue the journey with Ian, but Ian urges him to follow the tracker. However, Ian tells Chris not to listen when the tracker discourages him from bringing Annie back. As the elevator ascends, Ian reveals that he chose to look like Albert because Albert was the only person Chris listens to. Ian tells Chris to remember how he gave Annie the will to live after their children died, because he believes that it's how he can bring her back. As they ascend, Chris recalls that Annie was committed to a psychiatric institution after the incident. He visited her when she asked him for a divorce. Annie wonders why their children's tragic deaths didn't affect Chris the same way, so he explains that he chose to move on and live his life. Soon, the elevator reaches the top of a cliff where they come across a field of people's heads. While he carefully walks through the field, Chris finds Annie among the sea of faces. Chris runs toward her, but the ground collapses and he falls into a pool of water. When he emerges, he finds himself inside an inverted cathedral. The tracker tells Chris that Annie is in there somewhere. Chris notices a house on the cathedral's dome. The house looks just like their home despite its dilapidated condition, but the tracker warns him that the house is an illusion created by Annie. Before Chris goes in, the tracker stresses that people who took their own life are committed to punishing themselves, so he advises Chris to tell her what's in his heart and leave. The tracker then reveals that he's the real Albert. He and Chris's children chose to look different in the afterlife because their old roles were getting in the way of their true personalities. Albert stresses that he'll be watching out for Chris, but warns him that he has no defense against Annie. He notes that Chris will only have 3 minutes to talk with her. If he stays any longer, he will lose his mind, and he'll never return to heaven. When Chris enters the house, Annie doesn't recognize him, so he introduces himself as her new neighbor. Chris tells Annie that her old neighbor liked the flowers she grew. Annie notes that she can't grow them anymore, because the neighborhood no longer has water and electricity. She also lost several of her favorite things, such as her clothes, books, and paintings. Annie notes that she liked the paintings because they remind her of her family. Chris thinks that Annie doesn't leave the house because she expects her family to return, but Annie knows that they're gone for good. Chris tries to make Annie remember him by sharing that his wife took her own life after their children died. Annie gets upset and asks Chris to leave, but he keeps telling her about the last day he saw his wife. Chris notes that it was a special day that no one else knew about. He then recounts the day he visited Annie at the psychiatric institution to talk about their divorce. He told Annie that it was D-Day because it was the day he made a decision about the matter. Annie pointed out that decision and divorce would make two D's, so it should be double D day. Chris then explained that he realized that he was part of the problem because he couldn't join Annie in her grief. He told Annie not to give up on life as he was about to leave. When Chris attempted to walk away, Annie pulled his hand and hinted that she was not giving up on their marriage. Back in the house, Annie seems even more depressed to hear the story, because his wife still killed herself even though they reconciled. Chris regrets that he disconnected himself from Annie to remain strong. When Annie expresses her wish to see Chris again, he tells her to close his eyes and remember their wedding day. As they both imagine their wedding, Chris tells her that it's real. Chris tells her that she's been talking to her husband the whole time, but he fails to convince her. Before leaving, Chris thanks Annie for the time they spent together. When he gets back outside, Chris tells Albert that he realized he was right about the dangers of hell because he almost lost his mind. He discloses that he's giving up, but not in the way Albert wants. Chris then asks Albert to return to heaven and tell his children how much he loves them because he won't leave Annie. After returning to the house, Chris tells Annie that they won't recognize each other after a minute, but they'll be together. Chris forgives Annie for being so wonderful that he'd rather be in hell to be with her. Annie suddenly recalls when Chris told her that he realized he was part of the problem because he couldn't join Annie in her grief. Soon, Annie recognizes Chris. However, he has already lost his mind, so Annie tries desperately to keep him from forgetting about her. As Chris drowns in his nightmare, he recalls his happy moments with Annie, When Chris wakes up, he finds himself back in heaven. Chris feels disappointed that he's alone again. But Annie soon comes out of the house and approaches him. Chris embraces and kisses Annie after realizing that he's not just imagining her. After a few moments, Marie and Ian arrive to reunite with their mother. Annie can't contain her tears when she embraces her children again. Later, Annie tells Chris that she wants to grow old in their dream house with him. Chris, however, wishes to be reincarnated with her so they can fall in love all over again. He tells Annie not to worry about the children because they will still be in heaven when they return. When Annie asks how they'll find each other, Chris reminds her that he found her in hell, so it would be easy for him to find her in Jersey. Soon, Chris and Annie meet as young children, when their wooden toy boats bump into each other. Annie laughs hysterically when she sees Chris's boat capsize and sink. Not long, she approaches Chris to share her sandwich with him.
Subscribe to watch more videos like this. Turn on notifications and leave a like, it really helps the channel out. Thank you for watching.